So, the Merc with the Mouth now has his very own video game. Yep, Deadpool is finally here with his own hack'em, slash'em, and shoot'em-up game. But the real question is, will this game embody who Deadpool is from the comics or be the fake wannabe Deadpool that we saw from X-Men Origins Wolverine? Ugh. Let's find out.
Well, it's not like we get a do-over on this one. The hell we don't!
Deadpool is a very interesting and unique character from the Marvel Universe. In fact, Wade Wilson is so crazy, he's fully aware that he's in a comic and constantly breaks the fourth wall. Now that means talking to the audience. He's a zany character with witty and ridiculous dialogue, and that's why we love him. And this game brings that character to life, perfectly. The game starts with Deadpool contacting someone at High Moon about making a Deadpool game. Now, the fact that High Moon was the developer of the game just kind of shows what we're dealing with. Now, constantly cracking jokes, letting us know we're playing a game is just what makes the beginning of this game fantastic. Now, when it comes to the story, while it's very difficult to follow, it's almost as if there is no story, just objectives that make you think, oh, wow, well, I guess we're doing this now. Though this would be a very strong negative in any other game, but it really works in this case because we're seeing the story how Deadpool sees it, through his eyes. The voices in his head kinda get in the way, and he really just doesn't care. In fact, there's a prompt while Cable is trying to loop Deadpool in on what's going on that allows you to end it all now, and, well, he shoots himself just so he doesn't have to hear about the boring mission. Now, Deadpool is known for his combat skills and his arsenal, so I was curious to know how it would all stack together when it came to gameplay. I wasn't disappointed at all. You start up with your katanas and standard handguns, but there are plenty of other guns and weapons to choose from, all of which you can level up individually. The combat was simple, yet fun. You have two buttons for melee attacks, which combo together, another button for countering and teleporting around, and your standard aim and shoot mechanic. Felt a lot like the Arkham games, but with more combat options than just punch, punch, now counter. Though, with the promise of upgrading weapons and getting new combos, I found that this combo system was not as deep as it should have been. There were just a few combos here and there and nothing too extensive, though the kill animations were completely sweet. Now, speaking of kills, every now and again you'd have to take down some enemies with stealth. Now, don't get me wrong, these looked great and worth a good laugh, but at the same time, these sections were difficult to do due to the fact that you couldn't tell if you were still hidden or not, but if you could pull it off, they were super rewarding. Now, I did mention the ability to teleport. Now, this is such a great and helpful mechanic of the game, but mixed with the camera could become the death of you, literally. With some enemies, you have to keep teleporting to keep them from hitting you, keep them on the toes, but the camera would lose track of you and not be able to keep up, which normally leads to you getting pegged and being hit off a cliff. They try to keep the camera right on you to keep you in the game, but when you need to be able to react and counter so often and so quickly, it becomes more of a pain than a good thing. I'd also like to point out that if you still need some more Deadpool action, even after you finish the story, there's a section for challenges, which has you taking down waves and waves and waves of bad guys under specifically set amounts of time. Essential? No. But a good add-on. At the end of the day, when you're playing or reviewing a game, it's about the experience. And this game was one hell of an experience. I found myself constantly laughing at each cutscene. Hell, not even that. Every moment of this game was hilarious. The only other superhero game that portrays what it's like to be that character better is the Arkham franchise. And yes, I'm comparing this game to Batman Arkham Asylum, and it truly stands up to it.
Oh man, zoom in on Tubbo up there. Stop dropping my camera, player. Thing was expensive. Now get up.
Now, is Deadpool the greatest game ever made? No. Does it have its flaws? Yes, but all day I've just spent my time telling everyone that they have to play this game because it's so funny. It's definitely earned its mature rating, but all in all, it's a must play. Even if you weren't a Deadpool fan to begin with, you will be after this. So I give Deadpool an 8.5 out of 10. Now we just have to hope that they finally make that Deadpool movie and it's as good as this game. And also, if you want to see my favorite moment from the Deadpool game, go ahead and click the annotation that I've got over here. That's going to take you to my channel. Feel free to subscribe, but just enjoy the laugh and see really what this game is all about. Guys, till next time, I'll see you later.